All right, Josh Hodges here, Round Town, Episode 9 with Adam Helms, Director of Resident Services with the city.
Right.
Which, what's that cover?
Yeah, Resident Services, that covers code enforcement, nuisance abatement, and your trash and recycling collection. It's a pretty broad scope, deal with everything from making sure people are maintaining their properties, cutting the grass, not having stuff piled up. And then we also manage the Rumpke contract. So people from Rumpke misses your trash can or something like that, we take the call and make sure Rumpke goes back and grabs it.
So a lot of basic things that are just necessities that we, to have a society, we need.
Yeah, resident services is kind of the catch-all, right? You need a service and you're a resident.
But
we got you.
We're sitting here, River's Edge behind us. We didn't bring chairs. That's part of the perils of running a low budget podcast and letting an attorney do that, or me coming up with doing it, I guess. But luckily there's some steps here. We're in the shade. It's a nice day. You deal with all the stuff that we have to have, but I think you're known for the music, maybe even more. That's what I knew you did. So talk about that. Why do you love music, and why did you want to?
Yeah. So the coolest government job in the world. For a second there, I was Resident Services Incorporated, the golf courses. So
yeah.
Like I was doing the kind of not so fun stuff, and then golf courses and rock bands. So like that's the coolest job in the world.
Yeah,
running golf courses
golf.
And booking
yeah.
rock bands. That got to be a bit much, so golf courses, the Parks and Service, he's doing a good job with that, but the music, River's Edge, that's always been a passion project. I mean, when it got, I moved here I think in 2011, and when we got here, I knew like there were plans for this, and they were kind of moving dirt or getting ready to move dirt, but there wasn't really anything else going on in terms of music, outdoor in the summer, like programming. We had a smaller concert series that was moving around. So the year before this was built, we started doing shows on the show wagon. The city, the Rotary Club, I think, had gifted the city a show wagon in like the 90s. So
okay.
This was like 20-some years later. It was sturdy. It was
yeah.
sturdy. But we did some shows on that. I think we did 6 shows that summer. Just to get Hamilton familiar with the concept of, hey, we're going to do music, once a week or once every couple weeks, and it's going to be free, and it's going to be like kind of a rock show. So we did that first year, went well, and then moved in here. In year 2, and it didn't have a roof at that time. Like the canopy wasn't on, so we were still doing shows just like, I don't think the truss was set up either. It was just kind of speakers on the ground.
In the rain.
And yeah, like run for cover, a lot of tarps. That first year was kind of pretty bare bones.
I mean, thinking back has to be nice. I mean, to how tough it probably was and how much work went in probably just for that first summer to get people to believe in it. But now it's grown. I mean, you're Hamilton, we're kind of on the map for music now, I think.
Has grown beyond any of our wildest dreams. So like, I was so naive when we started this thing. I thought bands showed up with like their own PA system. And like, I remember the week before the band was coming to play, they're like, yeah, who's running sound? I'm like, what do you mean? And they're like, the speakers and stuff. I'm like, oh, we have to provide that? They're like, yeah. I'm like, well, like that's how little I knew about this. I knew nothing about this. So yeah, to have it go from, literally knowing nothing to getting a full on like, education on the fly, to have it where it's at now. I mean, there's a lot of people who have helped along the way, like David Shaw and the Revivalists, like that management team,
mm-hmm.
for not knowing anything about this. And I think our 3rd or 4th year doing it, they wanted to do a music festival. I'm like, guys, we just started doing free shows. Like,
yeah.
We want to do a music festival now. So there's been a lot of people who have helped along the way, teach us a lot. And the community is helped do this too.
I mean, I know people love it. I can hear it on Thursdays from my front porch on a kind of a quiet day. Sometimes I can hear the music. And you guys have overcome a lot in those times. I mean, we've had the pandemic since you guys started. I know a couple of the big shows, there was like awful rain. You guys were doing it under the parking garage.
Yeah,
I mean, you guys
yeah.
do it on the fly sometimes. And it's not easy.
We have a saying, I forgot what it was. But yeah, the rain has never really, it's stopped us, it's inhibited us, but like, that one time we had to move Big River Get Down all the way to Kentucky, like that's a feat. I never want to do it again, but like that's something that's unheard of. And like when we told
yeah.
people what we were doing, like that's insane. Like we picked up a whole music festival, it started raining here. We picked up at 3:30, trucked everything down to Covington. And I think we were up and running by like 8 or 9 o'clock.
And got it done.
So to like pick up all the speakers, all the band gear, throw in the back of a semi, haul it down there, unload it, set it back up, and like, we were dead, and people stood in like outside in the rain around the block, like they're just soaked. And I thought I was like gonna get punched in the face when I was scanning tickets when people were coming, just angry mob. But everybody was really cool. And like Andy, I remember Andy Frasco was like the first one to go on, and thank God, because that guy's a party in a can and just like brought
changed
life back into everybody. It was great.
Some people have that ability. You know, do you have any idea how many people, I know people come here from pretty far away. I mean, do you have some stats on how many people come to the shows and from how far away?
Yeah, so most of our shows are free, right? So we don't necessarily make people buy tickets, so it's really hard to track. But we do have some ticket data. You know, Big River Get Down is a ticketed event, and we allow people to claim free tickets or buy VIP tickets. And we have that on a map. And so currently we are missing people from Alaska and North Dakota. So if you know anybody from Alaska or North Dakota, send them to River's
Edge. Hashtag
that
in the video, maybe.
Because
we'll see
everywhere else, we have an attendee from every other state in the country. I'm at Hawaii, everywhere, and like three different countries too. So like we've hit, you know, River's
Edge. Isn't Gunderson from one of the Dakotas?
Come on, Gunderson's from
one
of the Dakotas.
We'll get Ben on it.
Right, for sure. But yeah, no, it's, I mean, it's great to see how far people come, and you know, the music is cool, but I think that's why River's Edge is so important to the community. Is, you know, prior to the amphitheater and what's happened around downtown, there wasn't really a reason to come to downtown Hamilton, especially in those early years when this got built, like 2012. The Markham apartments weren't here, Markham Park wasn't here. And so like, if you're not coming to Hamilton for a concert at 7 o'clock at night, what other time are you coming to Hamilton for, you know, midweek?
So, kind of seemed like it came at the perfect time, right when there was plans to do a lot of things, and kind of like just added on.
People come to see their favorite band, and they haven't been to Hamilton, and you know, hadn't been to Hamilton in X number of years, and you come back and you're just like, whoa, that wasn't here last time. You know, you get places like Sarah's House and just different things that started popping up on High Street, and like people who kept coming back for shows saw all the incremental change, like the bands who have been here multiple times. Like every time we come back, it's something new, and like they've seen the time lapse. It's been really cool.
I mean, I knew that I've lived in Hamilton my whole life, and I live right down the road, and I knew there was starting to be some free concerts down here, but I didn't really pay a whole lot of attention to it. And because there's music venues even in the county, there's other ones, and I just figured it's kind of like, nothing against local bands. I mean, some of them are great, but like, I just figured it, you know, you really pull some big names and some really high quality acts that people travel around the country. And I think it was my father-in-law told me first, he lives in Westchester. He was coming here for like Pink Floyd or something else. And I was like, is it good? He's like, oh man, yeah, they got great bands down there.
Yeah.
So I started, I came to a couple because he had told me about it.
We like local bands a lot. And we still book local bands, but one of the things, you know, people will travel to see their, you know, touring band because they're only around so often, and you know, local bands will play here and there, which is great, but when you only get to do 15-20 shows a year, we want to do something that, you know, people will travel to see and be special. Now, we still put local bands out there, like CFG and the Family is playing. We always have some locals on the lineup, but one of the really cool things is by doing shows over here, I feel like we've seen more music venues or opportunities open up for local bands.
Yeah.
So like take North Second Tap and Bottle Shop across the street here. Like that wasn't here before, you know, River's Edge. They do after parties after every show. They're booking local bands after every show on the weekends.
It kind of spreads out.
Municipal Brew Works is doing shows. You know, the Bowling Alley is doing shows. Like there's just more opportunities for bands now because we can only do two bands, you know, 15-20 shows, two bands, you know, what is that, 40 bands? There's no way we can possibly cover everybody, but, you know, I think a lot of other businesses around here have seen the opportunity that music can be for business and give a platform to local artists.
And you told me before we started talking, like anyone that gets in the music business that's not a rock star themselves was like a failed rock star, who wanted to be one at some point.
Everybody who's involved in the music industry is a failed musician at some level. Like I used to be in a band. I was a singer in a band. We were from Grafton, Wisconsin. We were aptly called the Graftones. Sounds like we should have been singing like Motown or something.
What
like
were
that.
You singing?
classic rock covers.
All right.
Rocking in the free world, man.
How old were you?
College.
All right.
But like, that's one of the things though about like local music and the music, just having music available. It was suburban Milwaukee, right? Where I was from, nobody was booking live music. So like on the weekends, there were no bands playing anywhere. So my crummy classic rock cover band was a big deal in that town because there was nothing else going on. And like, that was kind of, you know, there was music here, but like there was nothing like River's Edge when we got here to Hamilton. So like, music is one of those things that can rally a lot of people. It's really easy to get behind as long as you're, you know, putting accessible music out there that, you know, the average everybody can enjoy. It's a great thing for the community.
And it's just a perfect place to have it, really. I mean, with the park and like, I don't know, there's old houses here, new buildings here, the church, the river. Yeah. It's just like a nice spot, at least.
I mean, if
you
want to get down in the mosh pit in the front row, I'm just kidding. I don't know. Maybe we've had a mosh pit once. I'm not sure. But like, you can get down in the front row, walk up, or like, take the kids and hang out in the park or in between, you know, sit in a lawn chair, like walk about and go to the restaurants. It's a really unique, great atmosphere. I mean, I'll tell a story. Last year we had Charlie Crockett at Wimmy Diddle, and he came in the day before his show. He had a day off, and they spent the day in Hamilton. And like, we gave him rooms at the Marriott, but they pulled their tour bus over in that corner and set out lawn chairs and just hung out in the park in their tour bus for 2 days. They didn't even go in the hotel. They're like, this is great. Like, we got this park here. I'm like, everybody treating you right? They're like, yeah, nobody's bothering us. If they do, they're really chill. Like, so like, a band like that who's now, you know, selling out, you know, theaters, arenas, or whatever, just hanging out in Hamilton and said, this is awesome.
And you wouldn't even have believed you were able to pull that off when this started, right?
No, yeah, I had no way I thought we'd have bands like that. And that's not even like one of the bigger ones we've had. But yeah, just even having, you know, lights and a sound system, I never thought we'd have it.
That's the coolest thing about going for some kind of vision or dream. You never know where it'll take you or how big it can get. I mean, all you can do is try, see what happens.
Yeah, that's all it's been, is like a relentless incremental change. I mean, every year we try to do something different, whether it's new lights or a new element of the sound system. So,
as far as this year, is there anything new, since you're talking about that, anything big or what are you hoping for this year other than good weather?
We got a new PA system.
All
so
right.
Like the PA system we had been operating with came with the amphitheater, so it was like 10 or 12 years old. And for the level of the shows that we do, like the scale of bands, it's really on the small, like the small end.
Okay.
So we got a PA now that is essentially three of our old PAs put together. So like if we wanted to do a music festival out there in that big field, like this is like Bonnaroo PA.
Okay.
So like we may not roll out the entire PA because like we'll crumble the walls over
at the ability
or something.
Though.
But yeah. So like we have a new PA, which is really great. We built a new VIP platform we're going to put out by front of house. I'm not sure what we're going to do with it yet, but it's like the super VIP. I got to talk to some of the restaurants about like running food, and just that'll be like the closest thing we have to a luxury box, right? So like maybe there's 10 people that sit in there and we'll run food and drinks for you. And
that'd be,
you know,
cool.
Be a bouncer. You just kind of got your own space. Like there's a built-in bench and like tables and everything and umbrellas. So like,
it's always fun to feel important. Yeah,
yeah,
someone's
yeah.
Gonna
I mean, I don't know. Like, I don't want to feel too much like a throne because it's going to be like right when people walk in. Like, I don't know if I give everybody a scepter and a crown when they sit up there. But no, it should be a cool space, and we're looking forward to it.
And when do they start kicking off? I mean, I know it's coming up pretty soon.
May 25th, Thursday, and we go May 25th to September. If you include Cornstand Jam, September 30th. And there's only 1 week where we're taking off. Like that county fair week is the only week in Hamilton where we won't have live music here at River's Edge. So I mean, it's 20, I mean, Hamilton Pride's in there, Cornstand Jam is in there. It's not just all River's Edge events, but I think if you add those up, it's like 25 separate events here.
How do you, and you probably didn't know maybe how to do this when you started, how do you get involved and find the bands? I mean, especially the bigger names.
Sending out Hail Marys. Like you go and you find a band that you like, right? And you go to their website and you figure out where the contact page is, and you send an email to their agent and be like, hey, we're River's Edge, here's what we're about. And you hope that they say yes. And like, I've gotten pretty far. Like I've gotten in on some cool bands by writing heartfelt messages. Like for example, we got Tyler Childers to pick Wimmy Diddle over Bunbury several years ago. Like he was gonna play Bunbury. And I said, no, you should really come to Hamilton because like, trust me, it'll mean a lot more. This is a Rust Belt city, different than like where Tyler's from. And like, it'll be a lot cooler. This will be a legendary show, like if he comes and plays this, as opposed to playing middle of the lineup in Bunbury. Like, I'll be damned if he didn't agree to come to Hamilton, Ohio, which was really awesome.
That's all, yeah. So kids, if there's anything to learn, throwing a Hail Mary, sometimes it works. I mean,
yeah, just be sincere.
Yeah.
Just don't throw it up there with no hope.
It's not near as cool as rock stars for sure, or bands, but I mean, I've sent Hail Marys when I was first in law school or even first year as an attorney. I've sent emails to people who run firms with 500-600 attorneys in New York or California, and they're little contacts. Right. I didn't know what else to do, and they've emailed me back, and I've got to talk to them. So
you never,
all they can say is no, so it never hurts to try.
It's a challenge I never thought we'd get to, but like it was really easy punching up or like being the underdog. And I'm not saying we're, you know, the favorite or some superpower anymore, but it's very much like, I don't feel like we're punching up
as much anymore. It's expected now, that's different
kind of
pressure.
Yeah, so like it's maintaining, and like we want to do that. It's really special to me. It's really special to all the people involved. I think it's really special to the community. I mean, the businesses help out every year, which has been incredible.
I'm glad, talking about help, who helps you with this? I mean, I'm going to say maybe you're the man that helped put this together and it was your baby, but I know you didn't do it all by yourself.
Yeah,
who
so
helps
like
you with this?
Steve Maxwell is a guy. When I started this, I just had a crazy idea. And like, he was running the parks department at the time and he liked music. And like, nobody else really wanted to help. Like, they're like, man, that's crazy. Like, try it if you want, but Steve's like, I'm in. He's like, he knew this was coming too, and he wanted to get behind the music. So Steve Maxwell really helped get this off the ground, and like still helped with like the operations on the day of show. Like the big blue chair, did you see that thing?
Yeah.
Like he built that. Just built it last year and put
thought
that.
We
like
he, one.
Yeah, he's he's always doing like the fun stuff, figuring out where to set up the beer tents and like the experience stuff. You know, folks like that, Peggy Bangy. It takes 250 volunteers to run these concerts over the course of the season. And Peggy's out there coordinating and recruiting 250 volunteers.
That's a lot of people.
Our crew, I mean, like Tammy Rose helps out with the ticketing. There's a core group. We have a committee of people with various backgrounds in the music industry who help book the bands, like an advisory committee. Mm-hmm. It's not just my personal jukebox. Otherwise, it'd be like bluegrass and banjos all the time. But so like we try to be intentionally inclusive and diverse with the lineup. So, I mean, and that's just like the boots on the ground, like the labor part of it. I mean, every year there are 20 to 35 businesses who chip in money and sponsor this. Like the city doesn't say, here's some money, go get some bands. All the money for bands comes from local businesses, like the sponsorships.
It's pretty awesome.
They get a banner out there.
So if you see somebody,
if you see somebody's banner out there, they've given us money to go book a band. And it's not Fortune 500 companies either. It's all like mom and pop, mostly Hamilton shops, which is really cool.
Yeah. So, Hamilton, when I was a kid, I've always loved Hamilton, but, in the 90s, it wasn't the coolest place, to be honest. It had a spot in my heart always, but there wasn't a lot of stuff going on. And, with all the redevelopment and new stuff going on, and this just on top of it, it's like kind of helping really make Hamilton a happening spot. I don't even know when it happened, like what year, but it was all of a sudden I just kind of realized, like, man, there's a lot of people from not Hamilton coming down here for music or coming down here for other things. We're kind of getting known as, an art spot, music spot. There's more restaurants coming in. I think we got a lot of momentum, and I'd just like to say thanks, or at least on behalf of me or other people in Hamilton liking music, for what you've done here. I'm sure it feels pretty good to see when the crowd's out there. You're not a rock star, you're a failed musician, but you've kind of helped put all these people and give them something to cheer for, and so it has to feel pretty good.
It does.
More fun than giving them a ticket for
tall grass. Like that.
I mean, there's always their side of the coin. You might do that too.
That is the nice balance.
Yin and yang.
to hear the crowd roar versus the citation for tall grass, but
different kind of roar.
Yeah, that's it's been really great.
I mean, if you want to add anything about anything that you need or people in Hamilton could look forward to.
You triggered me on something. What did we just say? You're going to have to edit this now.
So no, we don't edit, man. You're stuck now.
Oh, man.
That's all good.
There was something you just said. I was going to make a really great point about something we were just talking about, and I couldn't get it out.
You can add it in the comments on Facebook if you can't remember.
Yeah. No, I businesses and lost it there.
Oh, sorry. The business is pitching in. Yeah. No, I need to do it. I need to pitch in. I haven't done that one yet. I try to do lots of stuff, but it's one of the things I haven't. So we'll have to sponsor a band or something.
You get some fabulous benefits. You get to.
Do I get in the thing with the scepter or whatever? Like the special
maybe,
room?
Maybe throw that in. Come to some shows. RiversEdgeLive.com. I'll put that plug in there. All the shows are up there. RiversEdgeLive.com, Facebook.
All right, set for the year. Yeah, I'll put it in the link and everybody can see that. And I really appreciate you sitting down talking to me. Sorry we didn't bring in chairs, but we're kind of like you first year. This is our first.
Hey,
this is our first season.
We don't have chairs at River's Edge either. So if you want to come here, bring a lawn chair, Josh.
All right. Thanks, Adam. All right, man. Perfect. Worked out. Didn't even need chairs.
No, solid. How many of these have you guys done?
I've
seen a few.
It's our ninth one.